Well, Singapore is developing a major national program to address its aging population and prioritise spending on it. The health minister says it will be as significant as Healthier SG, the country's billion-dollar healthcare reform. At the Agency for Integrated Care's work plan seminar today, Ong Ye Kung laid out systemic changes that are on the way to help people age well. Sherry Locke with this report.
Shuttling between different facilities is tiring, especially for seniors. What if they could seek help in just one place? The Health Ministry is looking at how a single provider can offer multiple services, for instance, nursing care and active aging. Or connecting different providers located in one area so they form an integrated network.
While each of our community provider does good work at your own facilities and settings, at the system level, the varied services can be seen as quite fragmented. Care journeys for seniors can be disrupted with multiple assessments as well as administrative procedures. And this in turn affects accessibility and impedes our effort to right-size patients.
Beyond physical health, agencies also want to engage seniors better so they are not socially isolated. For instance, active aging centres can connect them to other community spaces, such as hawker centres, libraries, or parks. And seniors can become volunteers themselves, which can help support these efforts. One corporation that's been volunteering with seniors says its programs will have to stay relevant and sustainable as these changes take place.
Particularly in the area of nutrition, particularly in social isolation, in the area of healthcare and general well-being, they continue to need this help. But exactly how do we ensure that the solution provided to them is relevant? So we need to engage with AIC to understand these challenges going forward.
To better support those seeking healthcare away from clinics and hospitals, MediSave will cover home care services. This will begin in July with video consultations for palliative care patients. From October, this will also cover those who need nursing services at home.